Hello friends, welcome back to Susan and John MathTube. In this video, we are going to work out more problems on power series method. In the first video, we got a rough idea how to work out problems on power series. And in this video, I'll put two more problems so that the method becomes a little bit easier. And in the next video, we will work out some very important questions from your past year's question paper. Okay, so let's start. So please write, solve the differential equation dy by dx plus y equal to 0. This is somewhat similar to the problem we did last day. Okay, so what we do is, we assume our solution to be a power series. That is a0 plus a1 into x plus a2 into x square plus a3 into x cube plus dot 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 to infinity. So remember, we believe this is our answer. And I'm allowed to do that because I know that x equal to 0 is a non-singular point. So remember, such a solution exists when x equal to 0 is a non-singular point. In the last video, we discussed how to find whether x equal to 0 is a non-singular point, etc. So, look at the order, the coefficient, and that's it. It's a non-singular point. Okay, now, the trick we use here is, we know that solution will balance the equation. But to make things a little bit more comfortable, what we do is, we write this series in summation format, sigma format. So it can be written as ak x to the power k. And when I look at the equation, I have dy by dx. So I'm going to find dy by dx. That will be nothing but k equal to 1 to infinity. I told you how this becomes 1 in the previous video. So ak k x to the power k minus 1. So that's it. We are ready. Now we will write, since the solution will balance the given differential equation. Since the solution, look at this. This is our answer. This is our solution. That means the same as this. This will balance the equation. So instead of dy by dx, I can plug in this quantity. And instead of y, I can plug in this quantity. I am allowed to do that. Because I believe that this is the solution. But don't forget the aim. Our aim is to find a0, a1, a2, a3, etc., etc., and plug in at the last. Okay, so the equation is dy by dx, which is the same as plus y is equal to 0. Y means k equal to 0 to infinity. Ak x to the power k equal to 0. Now, the most important step, that is equating. So, you can write equating coefficients of x to the power r on both sides. So, you can see that there are two summations in this equation. And every summation contains infinite number of terms. And I am going to create x to the power r on each of the summations. So, look at this. The power here is k minus 1. In the first summation, the power of x is k minus 1. So what I do is, I write k minus 1 should become r because I want power to become r. And then I will find k is equal to r plus 1. And that tells me if I replace k with r plus 1, then I will get coefficient of x to the power r. So a r plus 1 times r plus 1 plus, in the next summation the rule will be different. Look at the power of x. Okay, so I write the power of x and I want that power to become r. Then I calculate the value of k. Nothing to calculate. It's clearly k equal to r. It's obvious. So equal to 0. Now look at this. Now I'll transform this relation into a reduction formula. Reduction formula means writing the bigger subscript in terms of the smaller one. So we have the reduction formula, and that is good news. Okay, now what we do is we will put r equal to 0. When I put r equal to 0, I will get a1 equal to minus a0 by 0 plus 1, that is 1. That is a1 equal to minus a0. Okay. Now I'll put r equal to 1. So I get a1 plus 1. Look at this, 1 plus 1, a2 equal to minus a1 by 2. And that means a2 equal to, look at this, a1 is minus a0. Minus minus will be positive, so a0 by 2. Now I'm going to put r equal to 2, so I get a3 equal to minus a2 by 2 plus 1, 3. Now I'll plug in this value, so a3 becomes a0 by 2 into 3. Okay, that will be more than enough. What we do is we will plug in all these values in a1, a2, a3, etc., etc., because we assumed that to be our answer. So y equal to a0 plus a1 into x, but a1 is here, there will be minus, yeah, a1 is minus a0, right? So it's going to be a0 into x plus a0 plus a1x plus a2. A2 will be a0 by 2 into x square. Next one, a0 by 2 into 3 into x cube plus etc., etc., etc. And that gives me the answer a0 times 1 minus x by 1 factorial plus x square by 2 factorial minus x cube by 3 factorial plus etc. That's it. Now let's solve one more problem. So please write. Solve the differential equation d square y by dx square plus y equal to 0 using power series method. Now I'm sure that you know what to do first. So what we do is we assume our power series solution or our answer to be the power series a0 plus a1x plus a2 into x square plus a3 into x cube plus dot dot dot. So we believe this is the answer. I'm going to call it equation 1. And the principle that we use is the solution will balance the equation. And to make things a little bit easier, I'm going to write everything in terms of sigma notation. So the given series can be written as sigma ak x to the power k. Now when I look at the differential equation, I can see that I want the second derivative. Anyway, we learned that the first derivative will be like k equal to 1 to infinity. I told you the logic behind that. When you differentiate, this first part will disappear. So we start with a1 into 1. So the answer will be ak k x to the power k minus 1, right? Yeah. Now d square y by dx square will be, can you guess? Yep, it is k is equal to 2 to infinity ak into k minus 1 x to the power k minus 2. That's it. Now, as usual, we will write our dialogue. A solution will balance the equation. Don't use the word balance. Satisfy the equation. That is more mathematical. And the equation is second order derivative. That will be this plus this equal to 0. So I'm going to plug in those things. And I get sigma k equal to 2 to infinity ak k k minus 1 x to the power k minus 2 plus sigma k equal to 0 to infinity ak x to the power k is equal to 0. So second order derivative plus y equal to 0. Now as usual, I look at the summation and I'm going to write equating coefficients of x to the power r on both sides. Look at the first summation, the power of x is k minus 2. So I'm going to ask myself, when will k minus 2 become r? Of course, when k is equal to r plus 2. That's it. So replace k with r plus 2, I get ar plus 2, r plus 2, and then r plus 2 minus 1 will be r plus 1. Plus Now I look at the second summation and I ask myself, when will this power become r? Oh, when k equal to r. So ar equal to 0. Now we have to convert this into a reduction formula. That means you have to write the bigger subscript in terms of the smaller one. Now remember one thing I told you in the first video, that is, a second order differential equation will be associated with two arbitrary constants. So you're never going to get rid of a naught and a1. We will write the answer in terms of a naught and a1. So I put r equal to 0. When I put r equal to 0, I get a2, because 0 plus 2 will be 2, is equal to minus a naught by 0, 1 into 2. Okay, 1 into 2. That is 2 factorial. Now when I put r equal to 1, I get a3 is equal to minus a1 by 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 into 3, 3 factorial. Now I am going to put r equal to 2. So I get a4 is equal to minus a2 by 2 plus 1, 3 into 2 plus 2, 4, 3 into 4. But remember, I told you, I gave you one promise. We can write our solution completely in terms of a0 and a1. So this a2 should be replaced. A2 can be replaced with, yeah, this one. And minus minus will be plus. And a0 by 2 factorial into 3 into 4. Oh, 2 into 3 into 4. Okay, that's actually a0 by 4 factorial. Now when I plug in r equal to 3, something similar happens. You can try it, you can experiment yourself. I'm pretty sure about it. I'll get a1 by 5 factorial. And finally, we plug in everything into the equation, first equation. That is a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube plus a4x power 4 plus a power x power 5 plus etc. Do you remember? We called this the solution. Now we found everything, and we also know the fact that we can never avoid a0 and a1. So I should make it minus a0 by 2 factorial x cube minus a1 by 3 factorial x. Oh, this is x square. Okay, plus a0 by 4 factorial x power 4 plus a1 by 5 factorial x power 5 plus etc. So we get a naught times 1 minus x square by 2 factorial plus x to the power 4 by 4 factorial minus dot 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 plus a1 into x minus x cube by 3 factorial plus x to the power 5 by 5 factorial minus dot dot dot. That's it, my friends. So I'm going to wind up this video right now. In the next video, we will go through a few important questions from your question paper. So till then, my friends, bye.